Also was smart, very pricely, and the response has been strong. Varun Lochap is Reddy Managing Director and Co-Head Research with Religare Capital Markets. Varun, good morning. Thank you for joining us. Let me give you options. What do you want to start with? Auto sales numbers, why Oil India QFS was a success, or why mid-cap stocks are underperforming?
We can start off with autos, maybe.
Why are auto stocks holding on? Or dispatch numbers were not all that impressive. Are you a bit surprised? And do you think the kind of dispatch numbers we've got, are they indicating that demand is now contracting?
See, I think auto numbers were frankly not great, but at the same time, the expectations were also, you know, not very high. So if you see Maruti, I think they have, despite a low growth on a YOY basis, it's still marginally ahead of what we were expecting. M&M numbers are good. So I think net two-wheelers were expected to be weak. Hero Moto was slightly weak, but Bajaj Auto was okay. So I think the expectations are also low from the volume growth perspective, and on that the auto stocks have not disappointed, frankly. So we continue to be overweight on auto sector. You know, overall our top picks in the space are M&M, Tata Motors and Bajaj Auto.
Varun, what about the overall market? Because we seem to have gotten a little tempered and wobbly ahead of the budget. Do you think the market has already absorbed the positives, or is it just sucking up of liquidity because of the new issues?
Yeah, I think the second point is probably more valid. You have got a lot of issues coming up, which is sucking up liquidity from the secondary market, and that is why we are probably seeing Nifty being very range bound right now. But we believe come budget, around that time there could be volatility, but beyond that again the market could see up move, given the fact that government might come up with a budget which is looks quite good on the fiscal consolidation aspect. So we remain constructive on the markets from a 12-month scenario.
Varun, are you of the view that markets are running slightly ahead of themselves, because suddenly we're ignoring all the bad news and we're only picking up the good news?
See, that is true to an extent, but if you see in most of the, say at the start of the bull markets, that is usually the case. The data always lags behind and the markets start moving up. Having said that, I think one has to be cognizant of the underlying fundamentals as well, and therefore the good thing is I think markets are still not rallying significantly ahead of fundamentals. So we have seen a good up move in 2012, but if you see we are still at pretty normalized level of valuation when we look at the history of Indian markets. So it's not a big run up in the markets like we saw in 2009 when the markets were up 70-80% in a year. So and the good thing is people are still circumspect. There is still a degree of caution in the markets, and that is probably a good thing from the market's point of view.
So at Religare, are you of the view that for Indian equities the new bull market has started?
We believe that this year we should be ending the year with a target of around 22,500. So we could be making a new high sometime during this year, and we are in the positive camp definitely.
So Varun, what will lead us higher sectorally to that 22,000 mark that you're talking about?
See, banks is one sector where we are clearly overweight. Within the PSUs pack, again, we have been bullish for some time, and we're sort of anti-consensus 3 months back. So SBI we like a lot among the large cap PSU. Bank of India we like in the mid cap PSU pack. On the privates, we continue to like Yes Bank despite having run up. So banks is one area, one sector which I think is going to lead markets higher. We are clearly overweight on that. Autos in another sector where we are overweight, and so is cements. We also have upgraded our call on the IT sector, which is again a big weight in the index. We believe 2013 will be a good year for IT stocks, especially the large caps. So TCS and Infosys we are quite positive on. So I think these are some of the sectors which are going to lead us higher.
What about oil and gas? Would that also form part of the list, which would perhaps provide some leg up to the markets?
Yeah, I think oil and gas, we are not, I would say, overly bullish, but I think all the steps being taken by the government definitely puts us in a better shape. So if you see, oil and gas sector has been clearly underperforming the markets for several years. And when such a sector also starts supporting the market, you have, you know, all the more reason that, you know, market can remain well supported. So within oil and gas, we are not significantly overweight the sector, but we like ONGC and we also like BPCL, HPCL.
Varun, so you pretty much like 80% of the market. What is that you don't like?
See, consumers, we are underweight. Pharma, we are underweight. Utilities and telecom, these are four sectors where we are underweight.
Group, if I look at numbers, I think pharma companies have delivered. Lupin 20% growth, the kind of numbers we've got from you know, Cadila and other smaller and mid-tier pharma companies, they've been strong. So why are you slightly negative on pharmaceuticals?
See, we are frankly not too negative on pharma. If you pick between consumers and pharma, I think consumers is where we are more worried because of valuation. But pharma, again, we believe valuations are quite fair, and therefore, you know, you may not see a big leg up in the stocks. They have also been beneficiaries in last 12 months of depreciating currency, which doesn't look to be the case right now. Rupee again seems to have stabilized in a band. So I think pharma, you could still have, you know, stocks returning 10-15% easily in a year, but they will not be big outperformers in this market, we believe.
Varun, when we started the year, the consensus call on cement was positive. In fact, many brokerages were of the view that large cap stocks will extend further and mid cap cement stocks will catch up. But suddenly, large cap stocks have corrected and mid cap cement stocks are underperforming.
Cements as a sector, we are also in the bullish camp. We continue to be overweight the sector, with Ultratech being the top pick in the large cap space. I think what is happening out there is a bit like, you know, consumers. So you have a rotation happening in the markets to some extent, that the big performers of last year are underperforming right now, and, you know, the laggards are catching up, like oil and gas and IT. And I think cement is kind of going through a slightly lean patch because of that reason. But we believe, you know, given the pricing momentum we are seeing in most of the markets, you might see, you know, cement stocks again starting to move up. And you know, obviously post the run up, some of the stock valuations were looking stretched on cement, but we believe the pricing will more than compensate for that, and you will see on a 12 month basis some of these stocks don't look that expensive. So I think clearly they are just you know, undergoing pain because of the rotation happening out. So both consumers and cements, you know, investors are selling because they were big performers of last year, and they are positioning themselves in some of the underperforming sectors of last year, which is banks, oil and gas, and IT.
Okay, ICICI Bank clearly is the man of the match this Monday morning. 11992 for ICICI Bank, up 21 rupees. Volumes are okay, much higher than the 10-day average in terms of value. It is the top value traded counter, at least on the National Stock Exchange, in terms of value. 56 trading volume is about 3 million, but in terms of value, the total trade volume is about 56 crore. Oil India, both volume and value is strong. And United Spirits, which is due to declare numbers today, 1887 for United Spirits, up 21 rupees. Varun, in the near term, does it make sense to buy ICICI Bank? Because for 8 quarters on the trot now, they've managed to grow, they've managed to consolidate. Valuations are not looking all that stretched, and the CASA ratio also is one of the highest in the industry.
Yeah, I think within the privates, we clearly have a preference for say ICICI over Axis. Numbers have been quite good. You know, they have been the asset quality problem has been tackled very well by ICICI. I think the retail book growth is what is going to be the key trigger going forward. But we believe, yeah, valuations are also looking reasonable. So in among the privates, apart from Yes, which is clearly the top pick, I think having ICICI makes sense at this point of time.
So for someone who has to, let's say, pick and choose between Axis Bank and you know, ICICI Bank for rest of the year, which stock to your mind will give better returns?
We clearly have preference for ICICI over Axis. I think valuations are quite reasonable for ICICI, and we are more comfortable with the asset quality picture of ICICI rather than Axis.
Varun, what is it that you're expecting as a house from the budget this time?
So I think clearly we expect that government is in a serious fiscal consolidation mode. So the government will stick to its target of 5.3% fiscal deficit. And I think given that backdrop, you might see some increase in excise rates across the board, which might happen. And you will see some cut down on the plan expenditure side, which is what we are expecting, which could be slightly negative from a growth perspective for FY14, but I think right now fiscal consolidation is taking precedence over the growth.
Varun, whereas consumer names or consumer staple stocks are looking expensive, do you think within that group ITC still has potential to outperform? It's a stable business, cigarette business is growing, FMCG business has turned around, and at a time where in general FMCG sales are coming under pressure, this is one company which is still holding on.
Yeah, so I think that way ITC is slightly different and will not kind of underperform when the consumer demand slows down, which is clearly what you are seeing of late, that most of the other FMCG names are showing a drop in volume growth, which is not the case with ITC. And I think in this sort of an environment, it could potentially outperform, but the absolute upside even in ITC from these levels looks very limited to us given the valuations. So you might be better off in ITC compared to other FMCG names, but we don't think ITC can also deliver you a very high absolute returns from these levels given that valuations are at all-time high.
Okay, Varun, we'll let you go on that note. Appreciate you taking the time out and chatting with us today on the channel. Let's just revisit what the Nifty rate is up to. It's been a decent start. More importantly, we're back above the 6,000 mark, psychological mark, so to speak. The Nifty now at 6022, though it's tempered somewhat from where it started off. Mid-cap's doing okay. You've got a couple of stocks which are looking fairly active in trade. IFCI, Ultratech Cement, Adani Port, Tata Motors, Karnataka Bank, and PFC are some names which have made a very good move.